Hey friends, welcome back to my channel. You'll have to excuse my voice is a little bit funny. I've been recovering from, I don't know, like a cold or something, so I can't tell if I sound as bad on camera as I do in my head, but I feel a lot better, so we're gonna try this. So today is gonna be a paint my nails with me video, and I'm gonna start putting my base coat on while I talk to you. So if you saw my Welcome to Vlogmas video, then you know that I am filming a video every day, or excuse me, posting a video every day for the month of December is my goal. And so far, if I'm going according to my schedule, I believe we're on the third or fourth day right now. And my plan is to do a couple videos of in this style, this like paint my nails with me kind of chatty video style. And I'm gonna be reviewing some of the Topic Tuesday posts from earlier this year and some of the prompts that I didn't do. So I thought that might be a fun way to kind of catch up on those prompts and also get to do these kind of like chatty style videos that I really like filming. I feel like, so today I am doing the topics that were posted in January 2018, and some of them I either have already done a video for or are just like better to do in a full video than just chatting. And so those ones, you know, I'll let you know what the topic was, and either if I already have a video that covers that topic, I'll link it, or if, you know, I just plan on doing one in the future, I'll let you know that. So I just applied the Zoya Naked Manicure Naked Base, and I've been using this as my base coat pretty much since I got the Hullabaloo box at the beginning of October. And the polish that I'm gonna do today is this absolutely gorgeous dark blue with a small, like super small scattering of holographic in there. This is Indigo from Zoya. And I love this one. I think this one's gonna be in a video later this month on some favorite polishes, but that's what we have. Okay, so there are three questions from January. The first one is, when and how did my nail polish obsession begin? And then the second one is the best apps for tracking polish. And then the third one is, how many polishes do I own? All right, so I'm gonna start with the first question, which is, how many polishes do you own? I think that I own in the neighborhood of 400 polishes. I own about 350 or so Zoyas. I own mostly Zoyas, so my collection is probably, I don't know, 90% Zoya maybe. And then I have a fair number of Orlies because I have the ColourPass box now. And I have a fair number of Dimension Nails. They were like one of the first other vegan brands that I started buying pretty consistently. This polish is stunning. I'm so excited about it. I bought this polish like in May, I think, or maybe June. And I knew when I bought it that it probably wasn't gonna be, you know, like the most seasonally appropriate polish for the month that I bought it in, but it is spectacularly gorgeous. Okay, so the second question from Topic Tuesday in January is best apps for tracking polish. And I'm actually gonna do a video on this. I'm pretty sure if I stick to the schedule that I was planning on sticking to, this video is gonna go up on Tuesday, this one right now. And I think Monday before this, I'm gonna post a video about how I track my polish. So I use a spreadsheet, and that's how I track all my Zoya polishes. And it gives me a lot of information about my collection at a glance, makes it really easy to know, you know, which polishes do I have, which polishes don't I have, which polishes might be similar to ones that I have, so that I can, you know, make really informed decisions, which is important to me. So I think that video already went up, so I will link it in the cards up above and also try and link it in the description box down below. I feel like every time I say that I'm gonna link something in the description box down below, I totally forget, so forgive me if I do. It's on my channel, and I'll link it in the cards for sure. And so I don't really use any other apps. I would say I kind of use Instagram in the sense that it helps me figure out like what I've swatched. It helps me kind of keep track of other polishes that might be similar to ones that I own, etc. So Instagram is definitely helpful for kind of keeping track of my nail polish collection and how it, you know, is growing and changing and what I like and what I don't like. All right, I'm gonna do a little bit of cleanup here. My left hand always needs a little bit of cleanup because I'm left-handed. All right, I did my cleanup and I had somebody ask in a previous video how you use this thing. They said they bought one and it was kind of dry. Lots of companies make these, but I buy mine from CVS. It's just the like 360 Beauty, which is the CVS kind of generic brand. So the way that I use this is you take the cap off and there's a tip on the end here. And the tip, mine's gonna look kind of gross because I just used it, so I need to clean it out. But basically, it's got acetone in it, and it's coming from, you know, this central well. And it's not super wet, so the person who commented said, you know, it felt really dry, they weren't really sure if they were doing it right. The tip is not super wet, and I think that is, in my opinion, you know, I didn't design this thing, but in my opinion, it's not super wet so that you can be really controlled, right? If it was like a soaking wet sponge, it might like spill all over your nail and take off more than you want it to. I don't let the polish that I want to remove dry completely. I just let it dry for like a second. Like I'll finish, you know, the hand that I'm on and then go back and I just take the tip of my remover pen and I run it along the area where I want to remove the polish. And it, for me, pulls it right up. I do apply probably a fair amount of pressure, but I wouldn't be worried that it's dry because there is acetone in there and it does remove the polish. Obviously, you know, mine's got a lot on it right now. I'm using blue, so it stands out. And to clean the tip of this, I just soak it in a little bit of acetone and then I pop it right back in there. But they will get kind of clogged up and you can tell when it's not removing at all anymore. And when that happens, the brush does come with other tips in the back here that you can just replace. So the last one of these, I think I owned it for like 6 months and used it pretty consistently for 6 months. So they last a long time if you do that kind of cleaning out somewhat periodically. All right, I'm gonna go in here and do a second coat. It is looking pretty opaque, like basically a one coater, but I like to do a second coat just to kind of get super even and make sure I covered all the spots. All right, and then the last question is, how did your nail polish obsession begin? And I feel like my story is not that interesting and it's also not that old. I'm like a fairly new convert to all of this, but I was working in a school and I had a spring break and decided I was going through a pretty stressful time and said, you know what, I'm gonna treat myself and I'm gonna get my nails done. I never get my nails done. In fact, I think the last time that I'd gotten my nails done before that was like 3 years before this happened. So I went to the nail salon and I got a manicure and I'm pretty sure it cost like $22 and it was gel and I got gray. And so it was like nothing, you know, life-changing. I just got gray and I got gel and it lasted for like 2 weeks. And I don't know, I just felt so good having my nails done. I felt put together. I felt like polished in, you know, so many senses of the word. I just was so happy to have them done. And, you know, I think I mentioned to my husband or something how good it felt. And I just realized, this is silly. This is such a simple thing, right? Like I know how to paint my nails. I've done it before. I could just do this for myself and I could feel like this all the time. I was nervous that there wasn't nail polish that was like not terrible for you and not made with like scary chemicals. So I tried to do a lot of research about like, are vegan number one and number two cruelty free and number three are not full of crazy chemicals. And I found a couple and I'm gonna come back and do my top coat and finish my story. But the one that really stood out was Zoya. And I think Zoya stood out to me number one because they've been around for a really long time. They were used in salons and so I thought, okay, they must be, you know, pretty good. They're vegan, they're cruelty free, and they have so many colors. Like I was just amazed by their color selection. Yeah, so I found Zoya and ordered from them and started painting my nails and just became obsessed. I wanted to have them done always. I was so excited. So I found the nail polish community by looking up colors from Zoya on Instagram because I felt like there's so many colors on their website. How do you know what is gonna work for you? How do you know what looks good? Some of them look the same. I just felt so confused. And so I found the nail polish community on Instagram by following Zoya's Everyday Zoya hashtag. And I was like, man, there are all these people who love painting their nails. That's so cool. And I wanted there to be more comparisons out there. I felt like I had a hard time getting a sense of, okay, which of these polishes are similar to each other? Which ones do I really need? And then, you know, very quickly I stopped caring about that and just wanted them all because I thought, okay, maybe I can make comparisons for other people. And so really that's how I kind of started, was I just was buying Zoya's, and then I spent a long time just like researching Zoya's and just posting my swatches. And then when I started making YouTube videos, it was because I wanted to do the comparisons. I wanted to make it easier for other people to make decisions about which polishes to add to their collection. And you know, now, like I said, I buy all of them, and I think a lot of my subscribers buy all of them, but I still think it's really interesting to compare them all. So yeah, that's my story. I got one manicure and then I was hooked. And at one point I think I was like, oh, it's cheaper to do it yourself, you know, which is like definitely not true. Awesome, so this is my manicure. It is stunning. I really like this polish. The Scattered Hollow is like super invisible. Like you really can't see it unless you're looking for it, but I'll post a swatch photo because I think it'll come out a little bit better in that photo than it does right here. But it's beautiful. I love this kind of like metallic-y navy blue. I think it's so pretty. Thank you so much for listening to my story. If you're interested in hearing more about how I track my Zoya's, I will link that video down below and up in the cards. And I hope you'll join me for the rest of Vlogmas. There are many more days to come. Okay, thank you so much.